Hi everyone, welcome to my channel International Storyteller. In this channel you will find true horror stories worldwide. These stories are for entertainment purposes only. In this video, I will tell you the story of the legendary ghost ship known as the Flying Dutchman. The Flying Dutchman is a cursed ghost ship that has sailed the oceans forever, since it was unable to make to the port. The story of the Flying Dutchman is likely to have originated in the 16th and 17th centuries, which was the golden age of the Dutch East India Company and Dutch maritime power. During this period, various sightings of the ghost vessel were reported on the Cape of Good Hope in South Africa. Many claimed to have witnessed the ghostly ship of the Flying Dutchman sailing through the ocean fog, while others claimed to have encountered the ghost ship moving in the calm waters. But most of the sightings of this ghost ship happened when the weather was extremely stormy and a mighty wind occurred in the ocean. Why do you think this ghost ship is called the Flying Dutchman? A Dutchman is a male member of the Dutch people who is a native or inhabitant of the country, Netherlands, or a descendant of one. People started to refer to the cursed ghost ship as the Flying Dutchman because the ship's captain was a Dutchman. The story of the cursed ghost ship first gained widespread popularity in the year 1843, with Wagner's opera in German. Further, many artists started painting the ghost ship of the Flying Dutchman, which then captured public attention. The ghost ship also made an appearance in movies such as Pandora and The Flying Dutchman, released in 1951. It was made even more famous in the film Pirates of the Caribbean: Dead Man's Chest, released in 2006 by Disney. There have been many reported or sightings of the Flying Dutchman in the 19th and 20th centuries. In 1835, a British vessel came close to colliding with the ghost ship on a stormy night when the ship was approaching under full sail, but the ghost ship vanished mysteriously. An actual sighting was recorded by Prince George of Wales, the future King George V of the United Kingdom, who encountered the Flying Dutchman on one of his voyages across the ocean. He was on a three-year voyage during his youth in 1880 with his elder brother, Prince Albert Victor of Wales, and their tutor John Neil Dalton. At that time, King George V wanted to visit the East's colonial land that was under British rule. They start their voyage with the Royal Navy's 4,000-ton ship, the Corvette Bacchante. King George V records everything about his three-year journey across the ocean in his log. He records the encounter of the Flying Dutchman off the coast of Australia on July 11, 1881, in his log. On that day, the Corvette Bacchante ship was traveling off the coast of Australia in the Bass Strait between Melbourne and Sydney. Around 4 a.m., a ghost ship crossed their ship in the early morning. King George V, including the officers stationed on the bridge, clearly saw the ghost ship. They were all surprised and immediately moved forward to the front deck of their ship for further investigation of the ghost ship. But when they arrived there, the ghost ship had disappeared. When they looked around, there was neither a trace nor any sign of a ship seen, either near or far away from their ship. A total of 13 crew members, including the officers, saw the ghost ship. Another latest sighting of the ghost ship was reported during World War II. According to the reports, under the command of Nazi Admiral Karl Dönitz, a German U-boat submarine sighted the Flying Dutchman during their voyage through the east of the Suez Canal. It is believed that if the ghost ship was encountered by another ship, the ghost crew of the Flying Dutchman was trying to send a message to the people living on the land. Why was the ghost ship of the Flying Dutchman cursed to travel the oceans forever? What is the story behind it? In order to know this, let us hear the true story of the Flying Dutchman. The real story of the Flying Dutchman is believed to start in the year 1641, when a Dutch ship sank off the coast of the Cape of Good Hope in South Africa. A Dutchman named Hendrik van der Decken was the captain of the Dutch ship that sank, and this ship was owned by the Dutch East India Company. Captain Hendrik van der Decken was known by many people for the speed at which he sailed in the ocean. Some even believed that he made deals with the devil to sail too quickly. According to the stories, the ship was an Amsterdam vessel, which means a vessel from the capital of the Netherlands. Before this ship sank, it had been sailing in the ocean for more than 70 years. Captain Hendrik van der Decken was working for the Dutch East India Company during that time. He was a very loyal and devoted seaman. He would have his way in the ocean despite the God or devil's obstacles to his journey. Captain Hendrik van der Decken always wanted to sail the seven seas as soon as possible. Earlier, he had made a dangerous journey from Holland to the Far East countries to purchase profitable goods like spices, silks, and dyes. They eventually arrived after purchasing as many profitable goods as the ship could hold. He sold the goods and made the necessary repairs to the ship. This time, Captain Hendrik van der Decken thought of establishing a settlement for his employers of the Dutch East India Company, near the Cape of Good Hope in South Africa. He wants to use this settlement near the Cape of Good Hope in South Africa as a break from the storm and rough ocean waters. So Captain Hendrik van der Decken set out for Amsterdam, which is the port and the capital of the Netherlands, and from there he would start his voyage to South Africa. At that moment, his wife says tomorrow is Easter, the resurrection day of Christ, and a storm is nearing at sea. But Captain Hendrik van der Decken does not listen to his wife. He says that if Jesus or any God won't let him sail tomorrow, then the devil will. The next day, Captain Hendrik van der Decken started his voyage to South Africa with his crew. As the ship travels along the coast of Africa near the Cape of Good Hope, the wind blows against them more and more. Then a terrible storm hit the ship, putting the crew in danger. They failed to notice the approaching storm and the dark clouds emerging from the sky. Captain Hendrik van der Decken realized that they had sailed straight into a fierce storm. During the fierce storm, the crew begged their captain to stop moving forward and return in the opposite direction of the storm. But Captain Hendrik van der Decken thought the fierce storm and wind blowing straight against them were the work of God Almighty. He wanted to challenge the wrath of God Almighty. So he refused to listen to his crews and ordered them to continue sailing the ship forward. The captain and his crew battled for hours to get out of the storm, and at one stage, it looked like they would make it. Then they heard a loud sound because the ship had hit some hidden rocks and began to sink. Yet Captain Hendrik van der Decken still continues to move forward, challenging the wrath of God Almighty. He knew that his death was approaching as the ship began to sink. He was not ready to die, so he screamed out a curse that says, "I will round this cape, even if I have to keep sailing until doomsday." Thus, the ship and its crew were destroyed and were doomed to sail forever as a ghost ship in the ocean. The ghost ship of Captain Hendrik van der Decken has been given the name Flying Dutchman. So even today, the ghost of Captain Hendrik van der Decken, with his skeleton crew, has been sailing the ghost ship across the ocean. Many sailors claim that the ghost ship of the Flying Dutchman ship has led their ships away from the correct path, causing them to crash on hidden rocks or reefs. They say that if you look into a fierce storm coming off the Cape of Good Hope in South Africa, you will see the ghost ship of the Flying Dutchman, with a ghostly figure of Captain Hendrik van der Decken and his skeletal crew. But it is believed that whoever sees a glimpse of the Flying Dutchman will surely die a terrible death.